Baba Yaga's weapon. It's a scythe, but it's been dressed up to look like a witch's broom. Everything she did served the myth in some way.
This veil is mine. I have watered the ground and cultivated the dreaming blossoms. No one will enter. No one shall leave. I will not endure the outside world any longer. Here, at last, I am in control. I speak to myself. if only to hear another voice. It fills the space and the hours. But I have nothing to say. When the quiet overwhelms me, I try to sleep. I dream of what I've lost. I hope they died well. I hope that my dreams are only lies. There was a revolt, a bomb. The native people, the enemies of my enemies, rose up, striking out as we had always dreamed. Yvonne and our daughter might have known freedom, but instead they are dead. Killed by the only people that might have saved us. The Soviet cowards with me in the Vale say there is nothing left, that we must await rescue. They say they will protect me, but they jump at the dark, and supplies run low. There will be no rescue. I will live, and my captors will not. Survival is the only truth in this world. They are a superstitious lot. I slip the pollen into their rations, and when they are reduced to weeping husks, I will show them a new face, something they have feared since childhood. Baba Yaga, Grandmother Serpent, Witch. They will die screaming in terror. They deserve so much worse. If I cannot live free, then I will survive alone, in the shadows, until death reunites me with Yvonne and our child.
It is my great honor to have been given the responsibility of overseeing the construction of a shrine to the Apostles out in the Far Vale. The site is on the very borders of our newly founded city, through a distant canyon. The natural waterfalls and geothermal springs grant us an amazing opportunity to use our combined knowledge to create a place of solemn worship and reflection that glorifies not only the memory of the Apostles, but also our own recent advances in construction. Already we have outpaced the empire we left behind. We will arrive in the morning and break ground on a shrine to honor our past and the future of our city. Construction on the shrine continues. We decided to build our shrine at the top of the Vale, high in the cliffs above the river. In the lower parts of the Vale, where we quarry the stone, we constructed an aerial lift to bring cargo straight to the shrine. With all of our success thus far, I cannot ignore the ill omens. The two-headed wolf pup I found, dead in the forest, with the strange noises at night that no one can identify, and the murder. First in our new city. Two journeymen were feared lost in the side passage collapse. But one emerged, 2 days later, raving mad and covered in his companion's blood. We are no strangers to violence. But I cannot shake the feeling that we have crossed some forbidden, invisible threshold.
Thank you.
I thought I survived to spite my tormentors. But now I think I survived to spite myself. This is not a life worth saving. No life is. There are new people in the valley. I will teach them that this existence is not worth living.
Thank you.
The officer wandered out of the Vale, just as our rescue party prepared to enter. His body bore the marks of torture, a sight we knew well. The witch descended on them during the revolt, killing Seraphima along with her captors. He told us of the house that walks, of her fearsome voice. A child's story made flesh. He died the next day. Baba Yaga leaves no survivors. I wanted to go on, to bury your grandmother, but no one would enter the Vale after that. In the village, I learned to be a good man. I lived to honor her. I worked hard, but I dreamt of killing the witch every night. I might have gone years ago, had the fever not taken your mother. I stayed for you, Nadia. I am a lucky man. I lived a good life I did not deserve. A new fight is coming, but it is not mine. If I am to find revenge for Seraphima, it must be now. I go to kill the witch, to lay your grandmother to rest. I will not be coming back. Forgive me.